Guys, we have some breaking news, not regarding Call of Duty 2019, but Call of Duty 2020, because a Kotaku report suggests that Sledgehammer has been thrown out of their, I guess, development cycle. Now, let me go ahead and explain this, okay? So, you guys understand the Call of Duty cycle, you know, there's three studios, Infinity Ward, Treyarch, and Sledgehammer. They take turns every year making the new Call of Duty game. Of course, we recently got Black Ops 4 from Treyarch. This year, we're getting, hopefully, Modern Warfare 4 from Infinity Ward, but next year, Sledgehammer was supposed to bring in their third main Call of Duty game, which we didn't really know too much about. Now, a lot of rumors and stuff have suggested that the game would either take place in the Cold War or in Vietnam. There have been some conflicting reports on both sides of that whole thing and rumors going around, but it has been pretty much leaked, okay, that there were some problems with Call of Duty 2020's development. Now, it suggests that Raven actually was the primary developer of this game, and Sledgehammer was kind of alongside them in this one, which, I mean, if that's true, it seems like Sledgehammer's out of their spot as a main developer. But apparently, their game will not be coming out in 2020, and Activision has reportedly made the decision to bring Black Ops 5 with Treyarch. This is not a joke video, guys. I'm being 100% serious when I say this. This is what's being reported by Kotaku, which, let me go ahead and tell you guys, you might want to take it with a pinch of salt. We don't know 100%. It's not like Activision came out and said this. At first, I thought that's kind of what happened. I was like, oh my god, you know, I was kind of shocked. But apparently, this is just a rumor slash, I guess, conspiracy by Kotaku, which of course didn't really spill the beans on their sources, but, you know, this really does sound feasible, and with this game, which is reportedly going to be Black Ops 5, the game is apparently set to take place in the Cold War. Now, you might be asking, what are Sledgehammer and Raven working on then, if they had their game kind of shuttered? To be more specific, apparently their game was put on hold, which I guess indicates that eventually the game will probably come out and one of them will rejoin the cycle, but apparently for 2020, their job now isn't to work on this game that they basically put on hold. Their job is now to assist Treyarch with developing Black Ops 5, and with that being done, the reported Cold War setting that their game was supposed to take place in will now actually be incorporated into Black Ops 5, which means we might be seeing a direct sequel to Black Ops 1. I'm not gonna lie, that sounds pretty interesting to me. I mean, I loved Black Ops 1. I think it's probably the best campaign in the Call of Duty franchise. Obviously, Black Ops 1 is one of the best Call of Duties ever made. Black Ops 2 is, in my opinion, the best. And I think when it comes down to making a good game, all three of these studios working together could definitely be a good thing, because I think that, number one, that will mean that the game is hopefully more complete. Number two, that might also bring some of the best elements of all their games together, like Treyarch when it comes down to just the actual game itself. You know, Sledgehammer and Raven with their better microtransaction systems, hopefully. And of course, each of them kind of throwing in their own little system slash methods of making this game better. However, I mean, I'm just going off what's being reported here. If this is the case, not only is this a huge bombshell to the Call of Duty franchise, but this is completely unprecedented. I'd never really expected us to leave the 3-year cycle ever. And from the way it sounds, it really does sound like Sledgehammer is going to struggle to get back into the rotation at all. I mean, it just seems like they need a lot of help getting things done, and apparently the big clash between Raven and Sledgehammer is ultimately what costed them their chance to co-develop a 2020 game. But I mean, when you really think about it, you know, Call of Duty was really good on a 2-year cycle. I know that it might not correlate to anything, of course, but Call of Duty was at its best when it was actually a 2-year cycle and other studios were helping develop the games. Now, I don't necessarily know exactly why that could be, but if, you know, history is to show itself again, that might be a good thing for Call of Duty. Now, realistically, I see two scenarios in how this can work out. Either this is one of the best things Call of Duty as a franchise will ever see, or this is going to literally be the downfall. Now, let's say this is the best thing for Call of Duty. You get all these developers working together. They come out and they produce an amazing Call of Duty game. It'll most likely have horrible microtransactions. There will be things people don't like, of course, but a good overall title would really help the Call of Duty franchise. Now, I can't confirm whether or not this is what's exactly going to happen, but I mean, I think that if these studios can really put aside their differences, they can come together to make something really good. I mean, we've seen studios do this in the past in the Call of Duty franchise. And the last thing that the franchise honestly needs is a bunch of studios at war over the things going on in the franchise itself. I mean, come on now. But if they mess this up, then they've really messed this up. They've thrown the cycle out of whack. They would have, you know, completely disappointed the franchise and its fan base. Sales and overall profits would likely be a little bit lower than expected. You know, that doesn't hint towards very many good things. I would see Activision possibly taking some sort of repercussions out on the three studios if this game fails. I mean, Treyarch would probably get a lot less considering they have to step up and be in their element to kind of push basically everything ahead another year. But honestly, do I believe this? Do I believe that this is the case and this story is true and we're gonna see Black Ops 5 in 2020? Yes, I actually do believe this. Now, I know a lot of people are just really skeptical because Activision hasn't confirmed anything. Now, another thing, honestly, that I would say is really good if this is true. Now, let's think about these, okay? Because I want to keep this positive. I think that this really could have a positive outlook. And in reality, there are a lot more possible scenarios than we can really think of, but let's say this is all true, okay? And the campaign that had been worked on that is in a Cold War setting, apparently also going to involve Vietnam, is kind of merged together to be kind of like a direct Black Ops 1 sequel. I think that's going to make the community happy, just the setting alone, okay? And I would love for this to be the case. I loved Black Ops 1. That was my first real Call of Duty multiplayer. But another thing that is apparently being, I guess, rumored is that if this is the case, we will be seeing possibly a cross-gen Call of Duty. Now, PlayStation and Xbox just announced a couple days ago that they're actually partnering up to work on like cloud services, gaming services and stuff online. So in just like the last 6 to 7 months, we've not only seen Sony open up to actually allowing crossplay with certain games, they've also literally partnered with Xbox to work together. So this game, if it's cross-gen, this is going to probably be the first Call of Duty we've ever seen that happen with. That alone is going to add so much replay value to the game and be so enjoyable for players. And I really hope that this is the case and it would line up, because apparently the next PlayStation and Xbox consoles are supposed to come out in fall of 2020. Can you imagine Call of Duty Black Ops 5, a Cold War setting shooter that's based right after Black Ops 1, has an amazing campaign, a multiplayer that all three studios can bring their own charm to, a zombies mode, possibly more? Can you imagine playing that with your friends on PlayStation or playing that with your friends on Xbox, man? Oh my god. But on top of that, one thing that I think might really help, okay, especially since we see how incomplete, really, Black Ops 4 is, this would also mean that Sledgehammer and Raven, which Raven was supposed to step up and take kind of a main creation role for this game with Sledgehammer, they have a little bit of time to kind of reset and get things going. But unfortunately for Treyarch, that means they basically only have 2 years. Now, it seems like Treyarch is just hellbent on the Black Ops franchise, so I don't doubt that we'll see a Black Ops 5 eventually, just simply because it's Treyarch's moneymaker. I mean, people love Black Ops, people buy Black Ops, and at the end of the day, that's what they're gonna do. If it makes some money, they're gonna make it. I mean, let's just be honest and call it what it is here. Now, another reason that this whole thing honestly makes sense, when you look at it and you think about it, Michael Condrey and Glenn Schofield, okay, the two co-founders of this whole thing, the co-creators of Sledgehammer, both left last year. And then, of course, this was really honestly an ousting, I think. I think that they were kicked out of this studio, if I'm being honest with you here. And they left Activision altogether after taking some executive roles. Then they went and worked for 2K. Now, here is the problem with that. Okay, they moved on to 2K, and they started recruiting a bunch of Sledgehammer's developers to go work at their studio. Apparently, these guys were very popular in the studio. Everyone looked up to them, thought they had good vision, and they're leaving Sledgehammer in mass, basically, to go work for the studio. So Sledgehammer is losing all of these developers and losing their staff. So while they're fighting with Raven over what's going to happen with the game that's due in just over a year, okay, they're losing their staff very quickly to this competitive studio. And, I mean, what can you honestly do? If you're Activision and you're looking at it, you know Black Ops 5 is going to sell well, you know it's going to make money, you know that the idea behind these other teams' games can be incorporated into this. There's so much dismay and trouble coming with the next game. You see the backlash that the incomplete state of Black Ops 4 has brought from the community. Why would you even risk it? Everything honestly lines up with this whole thing. That's why I believe it. I'm 100% on board with this rumor. The sources haven't been outed, but I do believe, even though Kotaku kind of has a shaky rep when it comes to these things, this one is probably true. I mean, it's being reported that staff are arguing badly with COD 2020. It's being described as a mess. Activision declined to comment. I mean, there's a lot going on, guys, but I mean, I'm just here to report the news. I'm telling you guys what's apparently going on. We don't know 100% yet, but it's looking pretty likely, folks. Thank you for watching this video. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're brand new around here. Tell me what you would think about this whole thing down below. Do you believe it? Do you think it's fake? Do you like the idea? Do you not? Join the Discord down below. Lots of great things going on there. Follow me over on Twitter at SubToOptimus. I post memes, thoughts, and updates. I will also keep you updated on this situation over there. And until my next video, guys, this is Optimus. Waiting on Modern Warfare 4 to be announced, I guess. And signing out.